whether positive charge or negative charge. Number of lines emanating from a charge is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge. That you can understand from these two examples. Here there is a positive charge of magnitude Q. So number of lines are emanating. Then here there are 8 lines. This is shown by 8 lines. Here, since it is a positive charge, lines are outward. Here there is a negative charge, lines are inward. So here magnitude of the charge is double. Here Q, here it is 2Q. So the number of lines also double. So here it is shown by 8 lines. Here it is shown by 16 lines. So from these two examples, it is clear the number of lines is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge. When the magnitude of the charge is more, electric field surrounding that charge is also more. So here, charge is Q. So surrounding this, electric field is less compared to this. Here, charge is double than this, 2Q. So here, field is less compared to this. So field lines are not that much crowded here. So gap between the line is more. So here field is less. But here field is more because charge is more. So field surrounding this charge is more. So you can see lines are crowded here. So electric field can be represented by electric field lines. We compared the field here and here. So here charge is more. So field surrounding this charge is more. Here itself, now we can make a comparison. Near the charge and away from the charge. So near the charge, you can see gap is less. Lines are crowded. So here field is more. When we go away, gap is more. So field is less. Same 8 lines are there here also, but here 8 lines are passing through a smaller area. So here field is strong, intensity of the electric field is more here. Here same 8 lines are passing, but it is in a larger area. So lines are not crowded, here field is less. So electric field depends on the charge, magnitude of the charge, and also on the distance. This picture shows electric field lines near a charge configuration. Here two charges are there, Q1 and Q2. From Q2, electric field lines are starting. It is directed away from the charge. See, from the arrow it is clear. So Q2 is positive. For Q1, field lines are directed towards the charge. So field lines are ending at the charge Q1. So it is negative. Now we can compare the magnitude of Q1 and Q2. Magnitude of Q1 divided by magnitude of Q2 is 6 by 18. Here 6 lines are there, ending at Q1. So 6. Here 18 lines are starting from Q2. So it is 1 by 3. So magnitude of Q2 is 3 times the magnitude of Q1. So here more lines are starting from Q2. So magnitude of Q2 is 3 times the magnitude of Q1. This picture shows two positive charges kept at a distance. In this, we have to make a comparison between the field at A and B. A is near this charge. So field is more compared to the point B. Here gap between the line is less. Here gap between the line is more. So compared to B, field at A is more. Then if you count the number of lines starting from this, you can see it is 18. So you count this number of lines, it is 18. So here also if you count it is 18. That means these two charges are equal. Then at the point C, there is no electric field lines. So field at C is 0. In this figure, electric field lines start from Q1 and Q3. That you can understand from the arrows. From here, lines are starting and ending at Q2. Similarly, from Q3 also, lines are starting and ending at Q2. From this, it's clear Q1 and Q3 are positive charges and Q2 is negatively charged. Now, we can make a comparison of the magnitude of the charges. Magnitude of Q1 by Q2 is equal to 8 by 16. Because from Q1, 8 lines are starting. If you count the number of lines here, 8 lines are there. Here, 16 lines are there. Then 8 by 16 is 1 by 2. Similarly, you can make a comparison of Q2 and Q3. Q3 divided by Q2. Magnitude of that is 8 by 16. That is equal to 1 by 2.